You really can use fake flowers. This is the only time you can actually use fake flowers.
During Christmas?
During Christmas.
Why is that? Why is that?
Because when you put, of course, it's for safety reasons. Mm-hmm. And I mean, just for budgetary concerns, you can't always change your flowers in the tree or your flower arrangement because you probably have a lot of parties going on. So we actually say you can use fake flowers. And there's such a wide arrangement for Christmas.
Okay. So this is poinsettias and all of this. Is this what you're talking about?
Yes. Though there are a lot of more modern ones actually coming out now.
But some people still enjoy that whole poinsettia feel, isn't it?
But we actually say give it a different twist. Yeah. Like there's newer colors or you can dye certain... Like if you used to have a white poinsettia, you can actually dye it to be a different color.
Okay.
So, I mean, why let's update it. Exactly like this arrangement, it's a vintage feeling, but we actually updated it.
Okay. And we also have to talk about safety. Very important.
Yes. Right now, it's a big thing. Mm-hmm. Safety is actually one of the factors that we talk about when we do Christmas seminars. It's because... Now there are things called LED lights.
Right, because I honestly don't have Christmas lights in the house.
Yes, because it's actually quite scary if you make a mistake with it. And with LED lights, though they are more expensive, it is an investment. And the little that you spend is more of, you're not as worried.
Right.
So we do recommend LED lights. And then we also say don't overextend your Christmas lights, meaning don't put so many attachments to it.
Because that's what usually happens. Lines of extension cords all around
the house. Exactly. And of course, when you're putting up the tree, you're tamad to put another extension cord to make it right up the tree, especially if you have a high tree.
Mm-hmm.
So, but we say, just take the extra effort, have like someone help you out so it's not so stressful on your part. But it really, we want to be on the safe side. We want to enjoy Christmas.
Right, so of course. Let's just, without having it in the back of your mind that something may go wrong.
Yeah, and then, of course, don't leave it out. Like, off your lights when you
People forget that. When it's time to sleep. Right. I mean, obviously, much as it's really nice to have that glowing, number one, electricity is very bad for the electric bill. Number two, you never know what happens when you're asleep.
So, especially people who have a lot of things outside.
Right.
Unless you get outdoor lighting, this can really go bad. We really recommend if it is outdoor, take outdoor lighting. And if it's indoor, of course, there's many assortments for indoor lighting.
Okay.
So, be sure to turn it off. So little things like that we really, really try to recommend because we really don't, like you said, you don't want it in the back of your head.
Right.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, much as it could be a stressful time for those who are planning Christmas and all of this, we have to remember that Christmas is about you.
Yes.
So what are the tips that you have for making it about you?
Because like when we do a lot of Christmas decorating, we actually want to bring in the personality of the client because it's their house, it's their home, it's their friends who are going to come over. So we really wanted to have their personal touch. So one of the things that I was mentioning earlier was giving it, setting the mood.
Right.
So we do have scents. And actually, they do this a lot in hotels now. It's a lot of sensory items like sound and light. So even the mood of the lights, like we were talking about the tea light candles, that really helps you personalize things. And then, like I mentioned, the scent. So like a gingerbread scent or a cinnamon scent, which is very Christmassy. We do recommend not to mix scents.
Right, because can be overwhelming after a while.
And if you're going to, in one area, you should have one scent. Though if you like go to the baño, that can be a different scent.
Plus the scent of the cologne is different, the scent of the
It
the
gets a little bit, different. You might get nauseous after a while.
Right, because cinnamon is actually a very strong scent.
Yes, yes.
If you put too much of it.
Yes, so we actually do that. And then of course music.
Mm-hmm.
We recommend to put like your music of choice. So you want it jazz, you want it more like traditional Christmas. We do recommend that as well. And then we also do signature drinks.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, it's nice. You know, you have a red drink, top it off with a cherry. Those are the things we actually recommend is that you have your own bar and you do your signature drink. So you can even name it after yourself. Like, for me, I can make it...
That's a little narcissistic, isn't it?
Yeah.
But I'm thinking maybe Christmas is about you. It's good for maybe bigger groups because you can't, I guess, cater to everybody's needs.
Yes.
But like, let's say you have a smaller group and you know that two people like this kind of music or whatever, I think you should cater to your guests as well.
Yeah, and why not? I really, really think that if, like I always say, if your guests see that you put an effort into preparing for them, they'll appreciate what you're doing.
Excellent.
So, yeah, those are the things that... Other things that we recommend also are, like, different seating positions.
Right.
Like, you don't need to make it in the dining table. You can have, like,
a lounge area.
Lounge area, right. Or, like, a Japanese style where they sit on the floor. It really makes it personal. Right. I mean, when you do that, that's, like, really bring it to the next level.
Okay. So with all of the help that you gave me today, how can people out there contact you in case you're not that busy for the Christmas holidays?
Well, we always need more customers. So,
okay, so invite everybody
yeah,
to...
Yeah, we have a website. It's t.ph. And we also have a Facebook page. It's the Event Architects. You can search it online. And then we will also be teaching next year in SOFA. So you can go to sofamanila.com or look at their Facebook page as well.
Okay.
So yeah, it's going to be an interesting year next year.
Well, it's definitely a busy Christmas for you.
Yes.
Don't work too hard, Charina. And I'll see you around.
Yes.
Thanks a lot for today.
Thank you also.
And thank you for watching Shop Talk. I'm Lexi Schulze. Follow ANC Shop Talk on Twitter and be a fan of ANC Shop Talk on Facebook. Join us again tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of your day.